Can you move at your computer? Yes, sir. Yeah, we have to move the lights.
Yeah, let's be careful.
Are you going to be?
I need to make more though, because he's the only one I have for now. You know,
it's everything. We're live. It's okay, we're on a webinar. I'm everything. I'm definitely going to catch up.
Seat here, and is it if a person sits here? Okay.
Give me 1 second. That one will be fine if they sit there. Actually, we'll see. Give me a second. We'll make adjustments.
That looks like you know how it is. Good weather. All that snow out there. 10 degrees. I'm frozen here. I was telling my partner earlier today, I just came back to Carolina, so brought back the weather with me. Yeah, 15 degrees last week. 15 on Saturday, we're just going to do webinar. And the last minute, it said it was going to be 44. I said, we're going to live. So we are going to get started here in a moment. Let's put the other young lady from the studio. And this is.
Don't touch. Okay. Yeah, don't touch the
Excited about making some money in real estate?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. That's what I'm talking about. It's a fun game and lots of money here. So I want to make sure I follow along with my agenda here. Everyone has one of these, correct? Mm-hmm. All right. So a couple of house rules. So make sure if you have a recording device or a phone, just make sure it's on low, vibrate, something like that. We're recording, we're live streaming, two parts of the way we're going to be moving things. We're going to be live streaming out in a lot of times at our workshops, and we're also going to have live workshops. We have a combination of both. So in the event you can't make it in the future, you're able to just chime in online. You'll be able to get all the information, follow up with us, and follow us online, things of that nature. And I'll tell you who us is in a second. I'm going to write it up on my hand again, board here. So, we're still waiting on one person. Their Bible. Okay. All right. When she comes back, please just one more than you come. But you can hold it on here. All right. Cool. So, I think our guest is live from California. Hello there. Hello from California. Hello, Facebook. So I know people are streaming in from all over the world. Taiwan, and Africa, salute. I speak all types of languages. Homies, deuces. You gotta be, you know, multilingual in this day and time. You know, where things going? You gotta, all y'all, you're not as educated as I am. I understand you didn't get a chance to get through all that, all the languages. But don't feel insecure. I'm going to teach you today something we can level the playing field. But no, so I got these really big markers for some reason. I have some normal ones. So if this just starts making anyone dizzy, just let me know and I'll switch to the
normal.
I saw these. Oh, these look fun. It don't seem like they're writing there. But I'm going to put up here, and I'm going to move through these sheets. And this is going to be a visual interactive learning on real estate, how to find, fund, fix, and flip real estate. And I'll tell you a little bit about who I am. I'm going to tell you some expectations you can look forward to taking away from today. I'll tell you about my team. I have them introduce themselves. There'll be more coming. See a couple more people coming, so that they kind of set the mood for all of you. And just kind of let you know what you can expect and how you can get started in real estate. But by show of hands, do we have any people that's already flipping properties that flipped their first property? No. Okay. All right, perfect. So out of the people that sit here, do you just want to learn how to fix and flip,
rent properties or wholesale? All right, okay, cool. Has anyone not heard of wholesale before? Everybody know wholesale is? Okay, cool. So I'm just gonna put a couple things. You can take notes on the paper you have, and I'm gonna follow the agenda there. And then afterwards, we're gonna tell you about how you can become a part of our network. So my name, Rick, oh yeah, big old marker, long sheets. Rick Calhoun, they call me the real biz coach. And I'm not one that has ever picked up nicknames along the way. My nickname when I came up was LaRick, and it was LuRick when he shortened for that. So anytime I got in trouble, they were able to figure out that LuRick was LaRick. So as I got known, as I got younger, somewhere about 2 years ago, maybe 3 years ago, I was hanging around with a bunch of millennials. And it was like, man, you're really cool. You know, business, you know, real estate, man. And he's like, what do you need? It's a cool name. He's like, we should call you LA Rick. I'm like, oh, man, I'm like, I get to be. I said, well, I'll be LA Rick. I'll be LA Rick and hanging out with these young millennials. It was all between the ages of 27, 35. And I was like, I don't know if I want to be called LA Rick. It sounds like some type of gangster. Like, I'm supposed to shoot people every day. Whatever. Was he? Oh, LA Reed or LA Rick? Seriously? Oh, shit. Okay, I'm glad he accepted that one. But over time, somewhere in my spirit just dropped out this real biz coach. I don't know where it came from, still can't identify to this day. But what I liked about it was that it was about being 100% real. I also liked the fact that it had my background in real estate. And then it also had business thing. And then what I love to do, coaching guide people. So I was like, you know what, with all that being said, I will accept this tagline, this name, the real biz coach. And I will go around and I will help people move through their entrepreneurial and their wealth-building anxieties by being that. Why? Because I am 100% entrepreneur. Naturally. Everybody said, that's real.
That's
what I mean by that is, at the age of 11, I became an entrepreneur. And right around, I wanted to be a barber. And so I started cutting hair. Someone taught me that. I started cutting hair at 11. I won't go through the long story because it's not really totally relevant for the day. Single mom story, all those different things. But I wanted to make sure that I made money to take care of my mother, take care of my sister, like anyone going up in the neighborhood. School system that told me and convinced me that I was a learning disability, that I wasn't necessarily going to grow up to be educated and to have a life of luxuries and things that that people would have if they got the grades, get a good job, to have a good life. And so that wasn't going in my direction. So I ended up getting into the streets for a little while, 13 to 23 years old. I'm running around trying to figure out how to hustle and make money in the streets because they had told me I was not going to have a career. But coming out of 23, I got a big old slap on the hand. By the time I was 28, I was corrected. So by that time, I said, you know what? One thing I learned during my time of evolving and developing was that I had more in me than I was told. And I began to start trusting that about myself. And I started beginning to trust more about information I'm learning. And I learned the biggest thing that I want to teach you before we even get started in this whole real estate training is the most powerful thing that you'll need to know in order to make as much money as you want to make in this business is how to control your what?
Money.
Begins with an M.
Mindset.
So I read a book I want you to write down. It's called Dennis Bloodworth is the owner, the author. Key to yourself. The reason why I want to start there is that all I know is entrepreneurship. They told me in a little 3 years of work, now I'm 47 years old, 3 years I worked from Little Caesars to the city of Cleveland from 19 to 21. They said, don't even count. They said, Rick, you've been an entrepreneur the entire time. Don't even talk about those little 3 years. Just go ahead and let them know that you're real because this is how you eat, this is how you make a living. It's how you made upwards of $1 million. It's how you made, you know, consistently, even when the times are down, you're able to bring yourself back up and reinvent yourself on the dime and be busy because you are an entrepreneur. And in order for you to be in real estate, you're gonna have to understand the mindset of an entrepreneur first. You have to understand that mindset of being able to focus on what you want and understand that everything that you have or don't have is because of what your mind has allowed yourself to have and not have. So in order to be successful in real estate, before I even get into the details, you have to start understanding that the success is going to start in your mind. So when somebody tell you you can do a deal with no money down or you don't need any credit, it's really because they focused on the asset of real estate. They didn't focus on the credit. They didn't focus on the job. They focused on the goal, right? And the goal was to buy or fix or flip a property, and that's what showed up. What you think about most, you become. What you focus on most, it expands. All that stuff, it really does work. So in this book, He Yourself, it kind of helped me to recreate my mind to say, you know what, Rick, anything that you think about long enough, you can have. So once I learned that during my time of reinventing and my time of recorrecting, I ended up saying, you know what, the most powerful tool for me to be able to make wealth for the rest of my life is gonna be my mind. It can be funneled into what society would tell it, that you only can work this much, your degree will only pay you this much, and this degree will pay you this much, and this degree will pay you this much. This speed limit is what your car should only have to do, and that's kind of fair a little bit, right? But at the end of the day, the car say 160. Like, why can't it only do 35, 55? But there's a lot of limitations impressed on us in life, and a part of my workshops are going to be keeping it real to let you know that you won't make a dime with just information. That's why I see so many people fail when they get information. They buy all these get rich quick schemes because they never let them know the key to secret to success is really in their mind. So at the end of the day, this piece is where we have to start at before we can get going, that if you don't believe that you can make this real estate business work for you, it will not work. But the opposite is true too. If you believe that it will work for you, it will. So the short story is I ended up getting my barber license when I was 28. A year and a half into my barber career, I met a gentleman named Cortrell, and he showed me real estate as a world. He taught me things in the industry that he didn't necessarily know he was teaching me because he gave me inspiration, belief that the industry existed. Now, long story short, Cortrell didn't end up knowing the business. Cortrell wasn't real. But I ended up learning the business because he had gave me a dream. He gave me hope. And I blew past Cortrell, and I ended up mastering real estate. So much so he became a student of mine. But what I did in that short amount of time, I learned financing, which is one of the things he did tell me to do. I learned about mortgages. I did lending for 5 years. I learned about hard money loans. I learned about private lending. I learned about short selling houses, foreclosure, title companies, appraisal companies. I learned every single thing. I became a student of the game. So from there, I was able to build a very massive real estate business before the industry crashed, where I was buy, fix, flip. I was coaching people. I didn't know it was called coach. I was 37 years old. I had all those fancy cars that you want to have people, you know, see on TV. I wasn't flashing because there was no Facebook. But I did have, you know, all the luxuries of that, the houses, the money, $80,000 a month, $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 checks. So I've seen them. So it's real. It's not something I'm imagining or telling you something I hadn't done before. From there, when the industry crashed, I took on a career as a consultant in 2007-08. And I became a consultant using my same skills and my ability to think through business scenarios, which real estate taught me, and I'll get into that in another lesson. But real estate gave my capacity a boost. And so I became more astute in negotiation, more astute in sales. My capacity, once you get a $20,000 check, your capacity is different, right? Once you cash a $20,000 check, you think a whole lot different than cashing your paycheck. So my mindset, my boldness got up a lot more because I was dealing with bigger bang, bigger buck, bigger, you know, next level thinking people. So from there, I got into, you know, through the real estate business, it crashed, I got into consulting. From there, I was able to run a career doing more program development for real estate-based companies, church, nonprofit organizations, all that stuff. So give it all the way up to now, 2018 or so, is when I started getting back into real estate because the industry was coming back so fast, but there were no people out. It wasn't as many real biz coaches in the industry. Most people that you'll see in this real estate education industry have just started in the last 5 to 7 years, max, because the industry was down. So the people that got caught in it before, they kind of dipped off. The people that's new only know the new. So I'm kind of old school mixed with the new school. So I said, you know what, let me jump back into business. Got a couple buddies that's been doing really well in it. And I started about a year and a half ago, fixing and flipping my first property. No money down whatsoever. Fixed it, flipped it, sold it, before it even, when it first got completed, the first person walked in there and said, what do you want? And I'll send you pictures of that property. Then the second property, I got no money down and started fixing out. And from there, I said, you know, I want to educate people. So 2XL, when it was launched, in the beginning, was launched based on educating and empowering people to excel through real estate. The reason I always had this poster in the room is that is the original poster of 2006. Same mission applied then, applies now. That vision was back then saying that we're going to empower people to excel through real estate. And the reason we said through real estate is because we wanted to make sure people understood that you can go and launch a whole business through real estate. You don't have to empower yourself to just only get in. You can use real estate in order to fund your next dream. Buy it, fix it, flip it, take the money out, and fund whatever dream. And not have to worry about getting a business plan line at the bank. You know, with me? All right, so I wanted to kind of open up this kind of qualifying myself and then also qualify my team. A few of them are in the room right now on this back row back here on the side. Let's start with Patrice. Patrice is all our operations.
Hello, everybody.
So Patrice does all the back end, efficient finance, all the books, logistics, stuff like that. Make sure that we're running smoothly on our business side of things for the company. She's chief operation officer of 2XL. And then we have on the right side over here, Rob Lombardo. Rob handles, when we're done talking, Rob is part of our system. He handles your private money. If you want to say, how do I qualify to get private money loan or money loan, Rob will be the guy. You also see him show up in our system that I'm going to talk about today. Kim back there. Kim is a team member. Kim is the person responsible for Legal Shield and access to legal and lawyer resources. You're going to need that in real estate. We don't even start our membership without you having to get a Legal Shield membership because you have to have an attorney approve to us that you got enough money to just retain $1 to $500 a month. But if not, $45 a month or less, Kim will have you signed up and you have an attorney that you can talk to as we move through. Why is that important, Rick? Because I don't want you to trust in me. That's the one problem we had before. Everybody was trusting the guy because he was in a suit, smiling. I don't trust my smile, don't trust my suit. Trust your attorney. Contact your attorney. Ask them questions, fax documents back and forth. They'll validate and verify what it is that we just talked about. If it's some type of hang up, then we'll go back and we'll talk about it until we get it clear. But I wrestled and educated and consulted with attorneys my whole time. So we can have a conversation at any time. I generally like to say that I know a little bit more about this business than attorneys. But attorneys do bring an asset when it comes down to making contract details show up correctly. We have Erica back there. Erica is a licensed real estate agent and team member. Erica is responsible for doing the actual showing of homes as a licensed real estate agent. Sometimes you hear real estate companies talk about or flip houses, company programs talking about not using agents. I'm totally against that. You need to use a licensed real estate agent. They know the laws and they know contracts in your state and they keep you out of trouble. Whenever you got a licensed real estate agent in the deal, it keeps people from saying that you took advantage of them. All right, so utilize them in the front end to find properties. Sometimes you can find properties on your own in the front, but definitely in the back end to sell them. And sometimes you can just hire them outright as consultants to educate you on the whole process. Everybody got that? Patrina is going to be here shortly, but Patrina is responsible for our West Side properties, a lot of rental property management type strategies, things that I think just are going to get to rentals. That's where she's going to be. And Alan is going to be, Alan is Brusky, but we call him Brewski. Alan is with our partner company called Specialized IRA Services. Does anyone have a 401k? Okay, anybody does not know what a 401k is? So 401ks are vehicles that people use to convert, to be able to use for flipping properties a lot. So they do that, and he's a specialized company that allows and helps you to be able to convert one if you have it. But if you don't have one and you want to start one on your own, how many know you can do that? I didn't. You can actually set up your own self-directed IRA and start putting your money in as low as $250. And then start using that to build up savings to flip properties straight from that account. And it'll build as retirement. So you guys have an opportunity to build a 401k for yourself.
And Alan is on now.
Hey, Alan. All right. Hey, how you doing? Can you Can you see me?
Well, no, they won't be able to see you, but they'll be able to hear you.
All right, you can hear me then.
Yes.
Yes. We can hear you. I'll have you introduce yourself here in about 5 minutes and tell them a little bit about what you do. And
all right.
We'll see you in a second. All right.
Okay.
Any questions so far? Just kind of wanted to open up and get you all in the mindset of what we are. And then we're going to go into our class. Any questions? Okay. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go ahead, Alan. Go ahead and since we're doing introductions and giving you know a brief overview of what you do and how it will benefit everyone from a real estate perspective.
All right. I'm Alan Bruski. I'm with Specialized IRA Services, and my main title is Key Account Manager. And what I do is I work in unison with our clients to help them, first of all, understand the self-directed IRA, set up the account, and then help them with the whole process of actually doing the investments within the IRA. So doing an investment in a self-directed IRA, what the difference is between a normal IRA, the normal IRA you would be using it to invest in stocks, bonds, mutual funds. And that's typically what people do, but the government says that you can invest in real estate with your IRA through a specific entity called a self-directed IRA. There's two types of IRA. There's your regular IRA. Hold on 1 second. I got a big motor blowing on in my background here. Let me shut a door. All right, thank you. The regular IRA would be your traditional, your Roth. Some people have an SEP, which is a simple IRA, but for business. And the big one is a 401k that is a true business IRA. All of our IRAs are self-directed. And what that means is you direct the money. You tell us how you're going to invest it, where you're going to invest it, and we help you through the process. Everybody following me?
Yeah, right. Yes. Here, you have control right here.
So, all right. So you have control. You're the one that is investing the money. We don't do that for you in terms of we're not investing your money once we have it. We keep it in a position so you're ready to make a deal. It's there. Boom, you can get it done. With our company, you can get that done maximum 2 to 4 business days. A lot of companies take 6 days to 8 days. That's something we can discuss on how that is done and accomplished with a possible one-on-one with each person because everybody's situation is different. A regular IRA can be self-directed. A traditional or a Roth, you choose whether you want to defer the taxes or if you want to pay taxes up front and never have to worry about it after once you start investing. That's a Roth. The 401k is the supreme vehicle to self-direct in. That is a business account. You run it with an LLC, C-Corp, S-Corp. What you do with that is you have way larger contribution limits. The contribution limits on a regular IRA are roughly $6,000 this year, $1,000 more if you're over 50. But when you go to the 401k, your contribution limits shoot up to $37,000 for your business to defer off your bottom line and $19,000 to contribute on income from that business. If you're over 50, you get to put another $6,000 in. So let's say you have $100,000 in your account. You are allowed to, or let's say you've earned the income, I'm sorry, of $100,000. You're allowed to put 25%, like I said, or $37,000 in. So the 25% on $100,000 would be the $25,000 that you can contribute as the business, as the employee of the business, because you have both hats, you can now put in $19,000 also over and above that. So the power of that is you have money readily available to invest with your IRA. And the reason you want to do that is everything that is invested inside the IRA, whether it's 401k or a regular, is in a tax bubble. That tax bubble prevents you from ever paying any capital gains, ever. It doesn't matter deferred or tax-free through a Roth. You never pay capital gains. And if I'm not mistaken, that's right around 30% right now. Am I correct, LaRick?
Yeah.
All right, cool. That's huge. I mean, if you're a corporation and you can save your corporation 30%, you've got to be a rock star in that corporation. So this is a vehicle to do that. And even if it's in your own personal IRA, same thing. Real quick, I've got a gentleman who does an individual IRA. He has been investing for years, but he wanted to make sure that everything he did was in a Roth IRA, the tax-free. And what tax-free means is you've paid your taxes on the seeds. You've paid your taxes before the money ever went into the account, so that everything you do with that account, whether you're buying, you're wholesaling, you're flipping, whichever you do, every piece of profit that you earn comes back to the account, and it's yours tax-free.
Right. So
right now.
Oh, go ahead.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. This gentleman, and I call him our rock star, but we have people that are better, but he allows us to use his name. His name is Gary. And he earns $40,000 a month now that he's retired, completely tax-free. And that's huge because he only started 15 years ago with $4,000. And you say, how did he grow it? He grew it by maximizing his contribution and leveraging. The government allows you to leverage inside of an IRA where you have your money, you find a private lender or a non-recourse lender, you can't guarantee the loan, to purchase a property, pay down that loan from within the IRA, and then the property is yours. So over time, it just snowballed for him. In 15 years, he reached this from starting from scratch. And anybody can do it as long as they stay focused.
Right.
That sounds something that's good to everybody?
Yes.
Yep. And you all will learn more. Alan is on our team. He would have been here, but the weather was back and forth. So he has to drive really all the way here. But when the weather changed, as soon as the weather does, we ended up having him just on a webinar, just so you can hear and introduce himself to you. But I kind of want you to know, just out the gate, the product that Alan's going to be working with, the people that do not have 401ks, there's a minimum investment to set up a self-directed IRA account. And Alan, you can correct me if I'm wrong on this. You then begin to inject money into here. So you have some money that you want to invest, and at the end, we're going to talk about doing investment groups and pools. Then you would set your money in this account as $250 or $2,500 or more, $25,000, whatever you want to put in there. You put it in here so that they can now have these benefits. Taxes is protected, no capital gains, all these things. Now you're going to put this money in here. You're intentionally putting this money in. Be different than a person that's going to buy fixed flip and then go to the shopping at the store, because then you're going to get taxed. But if you want to buy fixed flip and keep the money coming back in and grow your retirement, for investment purposes, as one part of your vehicle, then you would use this vehicle, put the money in, invest into the project. If five of you to say, hey, we have $2,500 a piece, or four of you, $2,500 a piece, we're going to invest together. You all would put your money into this account, and then one, two, three, four would all go in on a property, and we'll talk to you about how that's going to work. And you all would be partnered on this property to invest into it, and then the proceeds, the revenue, the profits go back into your vehicle. Everybody understand what I'm saying there? So this is the type of account versus if you just use a regular bank account and we say, hey, look, let's get together and do some group economics and let's go invest. And you use your regular bank account, you put your money in, you make back some money, you're going to be hit with capital gains, all your taxes and all those ramifications. And you say, well, I made $4,000 or $5,000, but I had to give Uncle Sam $1,500 of it. That's why we have the self-directed IRA vehicle here. And if you just do a lot of research on it, you'll find that that's how people are playing a game in real estate. Yes, there are some people that just outright cut checks, and you can do that. And there's still other ways to defer taxes and certain things. But at the end of the day, this is the vehicle for us to do really strong wealth building. It's a strong wealth building vehicle. Oh, go ahead, you got a question?
So if you have Roth IRAs, other retirement investments already, can you roll
over? Yes, you sure can. That's what Alan specializes in. Specialized IRA services do that. So I will connect you all, and he's going to be a part of the team. So today we're just about him introducing into the concept so you can know that it exists, and you will kind of move from there. Everybody good with that? So that's the team. So with that, everybody ready to go into the real estate training?
Yes.
All right, come on. I'll get
woo!
You.
Yes!
All right, so just to show you how today is going to roll, we're going to flow through the information. Bear with us. We're going to go through some information on the bullet points on the flyer first, because I like to make sure I hit everything that I said on the flyer, because you never know what a person came through specifically for on the flyer. So I had on there about learning about off-market properties. I had on there how do I use my 401k to fund deals. I had on there how do I use private or hard money. How do I find good contractors? And why should I use the realtor to flip my house? Here's my goal for the day. My goal is to give you information that you can write down. No fancy presentation from a PowerPoint perspective, because I want you to write notes. It's once written, twice said. So at the end of the day, if you write it down one time, you'll begin to retain it. From there, it's experiential. So the second thing that we're gonna do, I'm gonna order some food, some appetizers and stuff. And it's going to come in shortly, probably right around 1:30. There'll be some wings and stuff like that. I'm going to order stuff. I love to eat when I come here. And then you can share it with me. That way, if you don't want it, guess who's going to eat it? So all you vegans and good old healthy folks, y'all just get ready to starve. So then I say real. I got to go back and talk to you about the real part. All right, so then, for those of you that can go with us, we're going to go down, right down Harvard, to a property that we're in the process of renovating. So you can get a chance to look at a project. When you leave out here today, here's what you'll have. The,
you're fine.
Well,
it disconnected.
What you'll have is knowledge on the ease of being able to enter the market, and empowered on the why you should be in the market, and then the resources to move you through the market. What you won't have when you leave out of here is the full scope on how to flip a house. I guarantee you won't know that when you leave out of here. But you will know that it's possible. You will know that 2XL, the Real Biz Coach, and our team can walk you through the process to get it done, and that it's affordable to be able to get started working with us. Inside this packet is a presentation that is for those that say, hey, I think I want to get going, a packet on how you get started and get in, either from a membership of $299 for the year that includes a RIA, Local Real Estate Investors Association, group meeting, if you just want to say, I just want to be a part. You know, I don't have no money to spend right now, I'm just going to be a member, and I'm going to come out to y'all real estate group meetings once a month. Fine. You have worst case, you're $300. Oh, best case, there's some $1,500, $2,500, $10,000 packages that you can sign up into to get going one-on-one with myself as I lead you through. I am not of the year of 2019 of the belief that I'm just going to educate you and then you're just going to go out there and make it happen. I'm just not going to do that. That's another deal. For me, I'm going to educate you, hopefully prove the validity in my knowledge, validate my knowledge for you, verify my knowledge. And then from there, you can entrust me and my team to walk you through your first real estate project. Is that fair? How much does that usually cost? Anybody know? Some of the packages out there right now? 15 what?
1500.
How much? Anybody else? 1,000, right? 15,000? 30,000 in our group that we just left out of a couple weeks ago. Were you there when that gentleman said he signed up? $30,000 package to flip. Gentleman, big business. Y'all can find him on Instagram. I'm not going to tell you his name. If you charge him $7,500 for your first property,
I know, I won't let you rotate it, but it's live now. Yeah, live now.
The big business charges $7,500 per person to fly people in from another city to our city to get to our inventory per person. And then you still have to have money to get into the project. But it gives you one property, which is a great deal. He's doing some great empowerment. And I'm saying at the end of the day, then I have a product as well. We have Jay Morrison out there doing real estate education. We signed up for a $97 online course. There's plenty of people out there to help you in business. I just happen to be one of them. My way is going to be hands-on, interactive, because that's real for me. And it's going to be primarily focused on the Cleveland market, because Cleveland is the leading market in the country for properties. And we're going to start off talking about that first. Why is it the leading market, property market? Foreclosures is one. What's the other reason? For our California guy. I'm going to start with that right there. This is a person trying to buy a house in Cleveland. They work at McDonald's. They make $2,300 a month. Manager. It's a manager. It's a manager. $1,800. Even out of that $1,800, half of that is $900. What they call a debt-to-income ratio. A bank will qualify 50% debt-to-income ratio. They qualify $1,800 for a $900 combination between the two things that you have to pay on a monthly basis, which is what?
Mortgage
and a car. Mortgage, two major expenses that most people have to have. How much car don't cost nowadays? A little bit to get around. You at least get out of something like $200. Call it $300. And then the average mortgage on a home that is $65,000, which is a nice home in this day and time. Matter of fact, we have some homes even selling at $45,000 fully renovated still in some parts of Cleveland. How much would the mortgage and interest, principal interest, tax and insurance be on there? About $500. $500 plus $300 is how much? Mm-hmm. Does $800 fit here? Yes. Can that McDonald's worker have a home?
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. Let's just move this person to California. Oh, by the way, this home is 1,300 square feet, California. This is a true story. 1,300 square feet or better, somewhere between 1,300 and 1,500 square feet, this house exists between 45 and 65, fully renovated. By one of our people in this group. They got this house below market value at about $10,000. It may be needed $25,000 in work. They ended up in $40,000. With fees, they were in it for, well, this is getting a little higher, but call it 40 all in, and they sold it at 65, they got a $25,000 margin in that house in Cleveland. People are getting the word out quicker than lightning, starting with Warren Buffett telling all his buddies in the stock market to get out about 7-8 years ago and get into Cleveland. And they all flooded. You ever heard of Berkshire Hathaway, the real estate company owned by Warren Buffett? He sent that here and all the agents and all the real estate people to open up this market because this existed. Not only did this exist, but this house at this price still rents for how much? 3-bedroom, bath and a half. Even higher than that, easily $800.
That's easily, on the west side, definitely. Yeah, definitely.
Yes. $800 rent. So the investor out of California says, look, if I could buy this for $10,000, put $25,000 in it. Oh, I added this wrong. That was $35,000. And I'm at $35,000, and I rent it for $800 a month. And what does my cash flow scenario look like? Because I'm not spending that much money on this money sitting at $35,000. You get where I'm going with that? So all over the country, people are trying to find inventory in Cleveland for one or two reasons. I can buy and flip flip a property with the guarantee to have a buyer because the market is balanced with the community's economic status. You get that? The other thing is I can buy, fix, and rent a property because, again, the average rent is not that difficult, $800, to afford a single family 3.5-bedroom in a decent part of Cleveland and still be profitable. Any questions around that so far? It's okay if you got a question. The property we're going to see today fits this scenario. We got it for $22,000. When it's done, we will have put about $25,000 in it. You get a math right now. Yeah, thank you. 47. The area commands as much as $89,000, or we could cap it right here and rent it for $800 a month, still be in this scenario. Or we can sell it and be in whatever the dollars is between, are between 47 and 89. So there's some other things that gotta come out of this amount. But there could be a max that comes out of that property. Got some fees and all the stuff that got come out of there. That's a fix and flip. But you see where the potentials go, right? So I'm gonna break this down slower, but I wanted to show you on this page why people are coming from all over the country to invest in Cleveland and why we have to wake up and not be the last one to invest in our own neighborhoods. So when people flying in, they're trying to figure out what the east side is like with the west side. Does anybody not know where Chagrin and Kinsman meet, or not where Shaker versus the west side, right? If I call an area, let's do it. Rob, can Rob hang out on 55th and Huff right now? Yes or no? But you see how your automatic intelligence walk in, right? Should we be excited if somebody give us a house for $50,000 in Solon that has 4 bedrooms, 2 baths?
Yeah, absolutely.
Blindly, you can purchase that house. Yeah. Yes? Yeah. You know, in Garfield, can we say that Garfield is near the west side?
No.
No, right? You see how quick that comes? So if someone says it's an 8,000 square foot house and it's in Garfield, what are you gonna say? You see how much it comes? Right? It's like, what type of house is that, right? So see how much knowledge is power. You understand your own market. That's why I don't get into people trying to buy in so many different markets. Like, if you don't know the market, you're breaking the number one rule that Warren Buffett talks about, which is know your product, know what you're investing into. So,
You end up with swamp land.
Got it? So that's what I'm trying to make sure that you know why, which is at the top of the sheet, which is why you should be investing in a real estate. That's one part of it. The second reason you should be investing in real estate is this reason. Private money, hard money, low cost inventory. These things I just want to have on your mind so you can remember. Private money, we're going to talk about in the second bullet point. I'm about to go back to my first bullet point. And low cost inventory. The last thing I'll say on here is the system is very easy now, which I'm going to do. I'm going to prove that as we move through the class itself. So everybody with me so far on why you should get into business, anybody think they should not be in the business? I know you're here because you want to be in business, but are you really convinced now? Who's overly convinced that they want to get in this business now? Got it? All right. So my first topic up here was, what are off-market properties? Anybody know what an off-market property is?
Property MLS.
Off that. What'd you say? Not in MLS. What is the MLS?
Realtor.
MLS is the multiple listing services. So outside of real estate agents, there's properties called off-market properties. when you see people put out a sign that says, we buy houses for cash, or we buy ugly homes, they're talking to the person that has a property that's maybe sitting somewhere that's available. Do those properties run out?
No.
They never do. So if you had a sign or you went on Facebook today and you test this and say, I am looking for a house to buy for cash, try it. Write that down as a note that y'all gonna try today. Because I want you to experience it. If you get a call back, you can call myself and Erica. We're gonna talk about it. I am looking for a house. I don't want to make a cash offer. It can be ugly. Matter of fact, ugly preferred. Right? That's what you want to say. I buy houses cash. I'm looking for a house cash. What that does is that allows someone to tell you about the house that maybe was left by a family member that just recently passed on. A house that they didn't know what to do with, or maybe they're renting it out and they have renters from you know where, and they say, you know what, I don't want this house anymore. I bought it back in the day for $6,000. I got my money out of it. I owe nothing on it. I want to get rid of it. Will you make me a cash offer? Most people are not going to call you to have a house on the market for $150,000 and sold. They go to, it qualifies them when you just say, I want to buy a house cash. You know, I know you're not talking about my house. So I don't have to worry about people calling you. With that would be the few and far between. You get me where I'm going with that? The reason why I want you to stick with this first note and really do it, because after you leave out here, you will be in the real estate investment business, whether you join anything I have or not. Once you do that, someone may very well call you. You can then call me, and I can qualify and look at that property to see if it's something that we can do something with. Wholesale it, buy it, fix it. A myriad of strategies that I can go through with you. If they happen to have a property that's worth $80,000 when it's repaired, what they call it after repair value, ARV, but they're selling it for $20,000 because it's ugly. But that ugly could go away with just $20,000 of work. You still got room in here. So if I could get to that house, and there's a lot of them out there, then I can help you see through that property and how much money have you spent so far? Nothing. Y'all starting to get the no money down strategy? I get in business, real estate with no money, no credit, no experience. I just posted on Facebook and just so happened on my page, somebody just so happened to have lost a loved one or lost interest in a property or whatever. Just finished going through a messy divorce where they're liquidating. You get where I'm going? A lawyer that happens to have access to inventory because it's a divorce lawyer. You just happen to be partners with somebody who worked at the county and said, look, I got all these properties and you can access them and nobody knows they even exist and they're here. You can come down and bid on them. You got it? So the first step is understanding off-market properties. Does everybody understand what off-market property is? So I spend all our time. Does everybody understand how to go out and get one immediately? Yeah. Right? Everybody? All right, let me know. And then from there, you understand how you will make money by bringing it to who?
You.
What?
So if you have, I have, I work for a nonprofit agency.
Yeah.
And they were asking, they had properties and then they want to get rid of those properties.
Yeah.
So are you interested in a property like that as well?
That y'all have in your nonprofit?
They're trying to get rid, they're trying to sell them all off. They're not.
Absolutely. Let's give a round of applause.
Yes.
Everybody thought that's my lead. But she about to slip your number. You want to tell me you got yours? The other restaurant. This is my favorite place. Y'all been, who hasn't been over before? This is amazing. This place is filled with wealth. The energy is all up in here with money. I just sometimes go up here and just sit around because there's so much money thinking flowing in this area. The energy is much different. Come up here, I use this now as my premier break. It's a little more expensive, but I come around, plug in. I don't have meetings here because I want to be around the money that's fresh. It does. It does. No more bingo clubs next year. All right. So. We got past that one. Everybody good with the one? It's just about awareness. Mm-hmm. That's where you're going to get your properties from. They have this thing called bird dogging. They're professional bird dogs. You can Google it. Bird dogs in real estate do nothing but source to get properties. They can make $5,000-$10,000 a month just in doing what we told you to do already. Post, put signs up, put them on your car. We buy houses cash. Don't have a dollar in their bank account. Talk about we buy houses. But who is we? Myself, LaRick, and I don't have it all, so I don't call somebody too. But at the end of the day, we is a powerful word. So when you say we, or even say I buy houses, but it's better you say we buy houses because you'll be more true and transparent. But we buy houses cash signifies that there's other people gonna be involved in the process. You call me, I have a pool of people that will buy those properties cash, and I have a pool of people that's already qualified in private lending, and you can be in that pool as well if you're on that side. And then on the other side, you'd be drawing properties to that. What happens is, just to peek into the wholesaling, which I'm not going to go into today, if we contract with this house at $20,000, it only takes $20,000 to get it fixed, which is $40,000. It's a $40,000 margin that somebody can make. Do you think a person minds if you sell them this house at $25,000? If they got to put $20,000 in it and it still got $80,000 in it? Right? So wholesaling is just adding a little bit on to this contract and selling it to a person that was willing to put the 20 in themselves instead of you. Everybody get that? So I'm going to pass that contract on to someone else, and I'm going to just make $5,000 and keep moving. I won't hang around to make the 40 or whatever's left here. You get it? So when you, if nothing else, when you leave out of here, be encouraged to just start. Even if you don't have no money to get started, just start telling people to call you for properties. You get a lead, you call me, and we'll figure out a way to make money off of that property. Got it? Mm-hmm. Everybody good with that? Don't walk out and say you're not making money in real estate. How do I use my 401k to fund my deals? There's not a lot of people in here that have 401ks, but Alan kind of talked about that. I'm going to defer that more so to him because Alan is the expert in being able to take your 401k, redirect into a self-directed, like you talked about earlier, and you can direct your own traffic. Most of the time, 401k, people's money is being marketed on their behalf or invested on their behalf. They're like, oh man, we lost. Or we want to look, I didn't even push the button. You lost my money, it's really bad. But they go back to the weeping too. So at the end of the day, it's saying that I can self-direct my own money, pull it into my self-directed IRK, make my own investment into real estate, the hottest market in the country, flip it back and increase my 401k. So that I won't go into much because I don't go into that for you. The one I really want to go into is how private money works. Who's used or heard, who has not heard of a private money lender before? Who has heard of hard money or private money? That's your hands. Okay, so this is where I really want you to dial in. This is the two most important parts of this workshop, is how you use other people's money in order to be able to flip a property if you don't have a lot of money yourself. So, you heard me talk about ARV. What does ARV stand for?
After repair value.
Thank you. So ARV is $100,000. And this is a true scenario we're going to look at. Private money and hard money lenders are looking for after repair values. And usually you want to be in this area. You don't really want to use a hard money and private money lender in the lower Cleveland areas because they have what they call a minimum that they want to loan. It's about $75,000 that they want to loan out on a property and up. So you can play a really big game with them. Usually they do like for you to have credit, but we do have one that doesn't care about credit. They usually want you to have a 620 credit score and above. But I do, you know what I'm saying? There's more lenders available this way, but we have some lenders that don't care if you have a credit or not. Got it? They want you to have experience in most cases. I'm putting high-end, low-interest companies first. Experience, like you said, if I'm never flipping a property, then how am I going to get access to funding? That's why we do group projects like the one Kim and I are on right now. Kim had never flipped a property, Kim and I are partnering on the property. She's investing, and then she's interacting with the property. And when we close, we'll close together, and she will have what?
Experience.
Got it?
That's awesome.
Credit plus experience. And the other one is down payment. These are three key factors, and it generally runs around 20%, sometimes as low as 10%. Down. So doing the quick math right here would be how much down on this particular price? At the max, 20 grand, right? And I'll get into deeper things, but I'm just trying to give you an overview of how it works. This property is going to be ARV, $100,000, which means at minimum, it should sell for about how much? Minimum. Well, somebody wanted to negotiate a little bit. Maybe 90. So from there, what the property itself we found for, call it $30,000. Well, not yet, we still gotta fix it. We say we're gonna put $20,000 in work in this property. That comes up to $50,000. Then there's fees. So this is the purchase. This is the renovation. This is the total. And then private money fees, or call it closing. This could easily call it 10%. Let's just make it $7,500. So all in all, we're in this project for how much? Okay. Now, flow with me. How much do we buy the house for? How much? $30,000 purchase. How much are we putting into it? $20,000. And I'm using numbers just to, you know, total, and then with the closing costs and fees on this first deal, about how much?
$7,500.
So the total is about $57,500. With me? What private money lenders are, I'll tell you in a second, but I'm giving you a scenario first. In this particular case, they're going to give anywhere from 60% to 80% of the ARV. Somebody tell me what's the lowest they're gonna give, what's the highest they're gonna give? 60,000, and the highest would be 80,000. So the most they're willing to qualify that property for is 60,000. I mean, the least. The most is 80,000. Does everybody think that deal will or will not close in the eyes of the private money lender? It will. The private money lender is saying, we're going to give you up to this amount. Say we give you $60,000, this amount. You now have to put down how much? I had over here, 10 to 20%. Mm-hmm. So how much do we have to put down on this property on a $60,000 loan minimum? Maximum. Y'all get it? So now what I'm saying is, if you just have $6,000 to $12,000, you can flip a property that's worth around $100,000 when it gets done, if we can find it around these numbers. Mm-hmm. So who are we calling? We're gonna put our little sign out, and then we're gonna call
A realtor.
Yeah. To say, realtor, can you pull up houses in a decent area that's worth around $100,000 that are between areas, price range of $30,000 to $45,000? You can even go as high as $50,000, because it may be $50,000 with 10 or 15 to work. And we still have room to go up. I just want to give you the basics. You follow me? Mm-hmm. Let me know if you're not, because this is important that you understand the distances, because it says that you can get started with this much.
Well, let me make sure I understand.
Go ahead.
So if you have 6 to 12,000, you say you can do this. I understand you can do that.
Yep.
If you don't have that, you can do what you said before. And invest with some other people, and then
Yep, that's a great point. So if someone was to raise their hand, and I'll raise it for you, you don't have to, say, look, Rick, I got a problem, but I don't have 6 or 12,000. That's the big issue. I'm here to make some money, so I can have that. I have it, but I don't have it to just sit no invest. Right? Anybody want to say amen to that, right?
Amen.
So then we go back to our scenario earlier of group economics, right? Someone said the other day when I was in Carolina, I've been on it for like the last 8 days. And it was all these people like us buzzing in this space. And one person said, now I don't have any feeling one way or the other about my president. I'm not allowed to, because I have to be neutral. I have to be sensitive to all spaces that I'm in. But they said, man, I want to thank President Donald Trump. He did make America great again, because if he hadn't been acting out the way he's acting out, we wouldn't be here trying to figure it out. They were in there trying to figure out how to work together. It's like, oh, shoot, this joke is crazy. Like, they don't have no jobs, they're cut off the money, like, everybody coming together to now figure it out. Upset is the opportunity to get to the truth. Everybody said that. Upset is the opportunity to get to the truth. So I just want to pause on my soapbox for a minute. The America is going to be great again, because guess what? We were always supposed to be working together.
Yes.
That division that you see, one power, the other power, triple K's, triple X's, all that stuff, it was never supposed to be. You know, we already got other countries that we still got to figure out how to make relationship with. So at the end of the day, it's like to break out into so many components in the United States was already a problem. So what's happening now is that people are now able to come together and work with the power just basically of synergizing with each other. So that goes to the point you just made. We may not have $12,000, however, we're in a room of hungry people. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 people in this room right now with just $1,000. We're doing this deal. When Alan showed us how to set up the self-directed IRA and us using the legal shield to make sure that ain't nobody gonna be Ponzi scheme. Don't put it out there. Don't be going on when I talk about I tricked you. I'm telling you, I'm gonna fire it back. I'm gonna say something. No, I didn't. It was class. So you then now have the opportunity. You can act like you're supposed to know each other, but everybody that built this plaza don't know each other. Wake up. They, matter of fact, it's better that they're strangers. Their lawyers showed up at a table and they said, we're gonna develop a multi-million-dollar plaza called Pinecrest. Who's in?
Yeah.
And they funded the area and they signed off and they're waiting on their return. And they're not like, oh, that's not my friend. I'm not gonna work with them. I'm not invested. I'm gonna be for Pinecrest. Pinecrest is not family owned. It's a bunch of strangers taking their money, pulling it together to invest. You all came out. I'm kind of lightweight charging you to be thinking about that. Now, unless you were here with some really deep pockets like Rob, you don't need this. Then, you know, but everybody else, consider it. That's why I made a membership network, not just a class, because I wanted you to know, hey, look, in a network, all things are possible.
Yes.
Right? So at the end of the day, we can go out and find a property. Right there. Now, if anybody's shorter than that, guess what? You still wrong. Because sometimes you can just get in and say, you know what? I don't have no money, but I at least have a good Facebook page that I can post and put signs out all week. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to be real today.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not going to act like this doesn't have so much.
Right.
You know, because I want you to leave out of here encouraged and empowered and not leave out of here feeling like, man, I heard it, but I still can't do it.
Right.
Like, that sucks. It's kind of how I felt when they put me on basement classes. It's like, Bob, why am I in this basement? I can't be special. I'm like, what
may be, but you can't comprehend. You just need to learn different. You know, I had to grow up and figure out that there was things were possible, right? So I don't want people to feel, I'm very sensitive around people feeling like things aren't possible. You got it? That's why I'm in the empowerment business. So everybody see this. Now, I want to close on this page by saying what a private lender is. And so we can, and we will order a few minutes, some wings and stuff. So what a hard money lender is what I'm going to talk about next. Different general private lending, hard money, they're about the same. But I do want to at least tell you what they are. Any questions on this scenario?
I have a question.
Yeah,
I want to check. Okay, the house ARV is valued at $100,000. Why can you?
One second, my boot back there.
Why can't it be purchased for $30,000?
I wish you could try to get my lead. One second. This young lady's trying to leave the track. Not get rid of houses. We got a wholesale. We got to wholesale her properties. But she's trying to get to the house.
No. Because she got to go
first. She does not have a job. So you're not going to home track. Don't let her out here. Right. Is also secure. All right. If you got to go, we'll just record it too.
Yeah.
All right. Well, this is the most important part. I can do it to the rest. All right. Question.
Oh, the question is. Why, if the house ARV is $100,000, why are you able to purchase it for $30,000?
Something wrong with the house?
Yes. Yeah. Who would say? Ugly house, nice neighborhood. That house could have been vandalized, took back by the bank because it was a foreclosure. Sometimes when a bank has a principal, say for a person had a $70,000 at one point, they paid it down to $30,000, $40,000. Still couldn't keep it, they lost it. The house goes empty, somebody breaks in, takes all the plumbing, all the electric, they strip it all the way down. Now, they have these people come out called BPO, broker price opinion, when they come out, the real estate agent come out and assess the house and say, well, normally this house will cost this, but all the stuff that it takes to fix it is missing. So now the current value, as it's stated, is 30. If it's repaired, after those repairs, the value is gonna go up to 100,000. You follow me? So that's how that usually happens. Y'all get that? That's why I'll be honest. And you know, we was a big part of a big wave. So there's a lot of inventory sitting out there like that. Got it? All right. Y'all too. I see. It's every class. I wasn't the only one. That's what see.
I got you.
Right. So now, so you get where I'm going. This is where group economics comes in. Now, the groups in this package talks about the lowest level group being $2,500. Three groups of $2,500, $5,000, and $10,000. That's been the norm. And I try to kind of put it there because I really, we can do any level, but we try to set it where it can be consistent and we can market to say who's got $2,500, $5,000, $10,000, and we put them in groups with each other. Still have to have so many people trying to figure out how to make this stuff work. So before Shirelli's, I want to go into any other questions on that because I want to go into what the harm of the lender is and why they do. Okay, so. Hard money or private money. You can Google them. Both of them are really close to the same. Here's the qualifications. Number one, they are a non-traditional. Lender. What's traditional? Name your bank. Your regular bank, credit unions, what immediately. You go to them with an ugly house and try to ask them for money, what are they going to say?
No.
You go to them trying to buy one investment property, they may say yes, put down some money. You go to them trying to buy multiple properties, they're going to tell you no.
Which is crazy because they're not in the business. They don't like the business.
Right, and that's the right. So that's where the area where they separate. So they're like, look, we're not into that. We're into deposits. We're going to just fund your regular transactions. So the only way you really get into real estate investing is you must be utilizing your own credit, or your own cash, or a private hard money lender are the main two ways. Or if you have a self-directed, which is still your own cash. Now get that, because these people are set up to deal with real estate. They only deal with businesses. One of the things that we're going to have to help you with is setting you up an LLC. It's called business-to-business lending, right? So the hard money lender moves around the banking laws because they're only making a loan from a business to a business. They can't give you money at the interest rates they give you at without going through all these different bells and whistles with the government and laws and all that stuff. If you are a person, an individual, you must be making an investment. In real estate, don't call a hard money lender asking them to give you a hard money loan on a restaurant. That's not what they do. They only fund real estate businesses. Everybody get that? How they are made up is, remember they talk about the 401ks? If people have a 401k and they all put their 401k into the lender's account, they point it there, and some put cash. But mainly people redirect their self-directed IRA and they put it into this account, and this broker, now known as a hard money lender or a private money lender, turns around and lends it out to this house based on this person's dream of buying and fixing and flipping like we have on the other side. The promise that they're making back to these people is called 12 to 17% return on investment interest. So this person is saying, no, I know I can self-direct my money and go out and flip a house like in that scenario, but I don't know any contractors. I'm older, I'm at work, I don't want to get into that. But I do want my money to make more money. So I'm just going to get my money with a private lending company or start one of my own and lend money to people that want to go do all of that. Let me just sound on the page. Everybody get that? So with that being said, how they make their money is those fees we talked about earlier. Anywhere from 5 to 10% on the deal that we just talked about. So they make a fee for closing the deal, and then there's interest payments that you pay like a credit card every month until you return the money. Their terms are usually 6 months to as high as 3 years. They're interested in the asset, not you. But they do like to see people that have proven that they pay their credit, they have credit worthiness and things of that nature in most cases. Like I said, we have a lender that doesn't care, but we have a lot of them that do care. But at the end of the day, you have options. They owe these people back money, so they don't want to get their money out on the hook. You got it? 6 month to 3 year terms. And in those 3 year terms, you have to have sold that property or refinanced out of that property with a traditional lender so they can get their money back and give it to another investor. Everybody okay with that? And let's see, anything else about a hard money lender? You know where they get their money from. Generally, people with cash or 401ks that put their money with this broker. There's a lot of them out there, a lot of them that are not as full in integrity. So they will have you do appraisal monies and stuff like that up front and not hold the deal. So you want to have some guidance in using them. All hard monies are not good. And all private lenders. So some of them put you in a setup position and they take the property right back after you put your money in down payment and stuff. And they're like, up you lose, I got the property. Thanks for finding it. Thanks for starting to fix it. We'll take it from here. So that's where you want to use coaching. And then let's see, you see the terms, 5 to 10%. They specialize in ugly houses. You have to have an LLC, We can set up your LLC for as little as $275, or you can go online and give a shot at yourself. File fees only $99. You can do it right online in the state of Ohio. If you need help doing it, usually we have an attorney or accountant who will stand by and we'll do it for $275 to add the right language in that. Anybody already have an LLC? Okay. Who doesn't have an LLC? Okay. So we can help you if you want to get started with that. You don't need an LLC in order to do the group purchasing. We'll talk to you about how we need to get that set up, and we'll use the self-directed IRA to kind of begin to act as a protection, and we'll talk about how it works. Any questions on what a hard money lender is and private money lender is? Do you feel like you understand, like if somebody came to you, what they are and why they do what they do? So why does a person that's a broker of a hard money lender, why do they exist to do what? To help people get into investment properties. How much do they charge for their services? 5 to 10%. Got it? How much do they pay on average to the people that they get their money from?
Total
17%. Can you invest your money into a hard money, private money lender? No, you don't have to have a business to invest it in.
Oh.
You have to have a business to get it.
Oh, right. Yes.
Yes, right? And how much, if you put your money into the broker, the hard money lender, how much would you make back? 12 to 17%. If you were the person putting the money into the broker, right? And the reason I want you to know that is because you, the more you know the business, the more confident you feel around that. Got it? The more confident you feel about negotiating. Got it? Ask me a question. Anybody have a question over here?
So you said only invest in real estate.
Yeah.
Residential real estate, not commercial real estate?
Good question. So residential or commercial? Residential and commercial, you have single family, two family, three family, four family is usually residential, up to into a five. Six meters and above are commercial. You got commercial residential, you have what they call mixed use, which we'll get into later, which we have apartments and storefronts in the building. You have just strictly standalone commercial, which is here without the residential side. Hard money lenders will qualify and fund any of those. Any one of them. If it's real estate, they'll fund it. So you have different ones, some don't deal with commercial, but they all will do it if it's real estate related. And the terms are generally about the same. Hard money lenders also do refinances, which you don't have to get into today, but you own the property. And you just want to do a refinance to fix it up. You can't live in the house, you must be buying it to sell it. The reason I want to spend so much time over here is because this is what makes you able to leave out here today, able to invest, because we have a private money lender on our team. We have a multitude of them that we've already vetted and qualified that we can utilize, that we will utilize as you move through the program. Got it? All right. Lastly, how do I find good contractors?
Ooh.
Got it?
I have a question about
this. Yes.
You said you can't live, so if you first say two family, you can't live in any of those things. You have to be buying it to rent out or sell.
Yes. Yep. Now, you get at the end, your back end intention could have been like, well, once I fix it and done with it, I'm going to buy it back myself. Totally fine. The intention in the beginning has to be to make an investment. You decide you want to buy it to refinance it out and then rent it out for yourself, a little one floor, totally fine. You just can't live in there while you're renting, while you're on them or their time. You're not supposed to. You all have that?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I want to stop and ask first before I go into the contractor part, what questions in real estate, period, that you have, and I'm gonna ask each person, just so I can make sure there's something that you specifically have. You know what, I always wonder about this in real estate. What would you say? Got one? Nothing so far? All right, go ahead.
So let's say you have a home and you SP off. Mm-hmm.
That's a great question. If you have a home that's free and clear, which she's asking, I don't owe anything on it, is it better for me to take the equity out of that property and use it to invest or go to a hard money lender? Or I add a third one, which is kind of both. So the answer depends. One thing that depends on is the property value. Like if it's enough value there, your credit scenario to be able to pull the money out says, oh yeah, well, I definitely will pull my money out first because you are then becoming your first lender. So it's like, well, if I'm gonna give you a promise, I'm gonna give myself that same promise. My fees are gonna be lower, the interest I'm paying back to myself, all the benefits are back on me. So I become my first lender. If you don't have the credit to be able to do so, then sometimes, depending on hard money lender, we can sometimes use that as a property within your relationship within your family to buy that property using the hard money to pull the money out. Or sometimes they're like, if you finance it, you can show that you're going to be offering selling the house rather than not buying. But the simple answer is yes, it's better for you to utilize your, because it's going to be the same thing. You take it out alone, and then you're going to go and buy, fix the flip, or use it as a deposit. You know, your down payment. So that's exactly, yes, that's the answer, yes.
One point to make with that, though, is it just depends on timing. So with private money and hard money, we get access to the funds a lot quicker. So if you are trying to, if you anticipate purchasing a house and, like, you know that maybe in 30 days it's going to become available, well, great, you can do that, refinance it, and get access to your funds unless it's going to be a line of credit. But if you do, like, a standard cash out refinance, it may take you so long to get the funds closed and have the money deposited in your account, but that house is already gone because the housing market's so high. Right. So private money and hard money, they give you access to funds in 7 to 14 days, so much quicker to make that move.
Yeah.
But yeah, it is cheaper to be able to pull one out yourself. And then also the difference in funds. You might be able to get access, you know, whatever you have on hand for your own value, but private money can pay potentially different for it.
Yes. All right. That sounds great. So you're going to do that and you start early and get that money out and then start closing. Because the reason to the time to close to get it. So we have a simple solution in our team for contractors. So I'll talk to you about one and I'll tell you about our solution that we're working on. We have a company that's in our system. I won't name them today, because we're in the process of formalizing our relationship. They have an online platform that allows you to upload pictures and information around your project, videos. You can walk through the house, totally don't know anything about real estate. This is why I said it's the number one time to get real estate, because I had to hustle this back in. I had to figure it out. So you walk through with a video camera and say, I don't know what I'm looking at, I don't know what I'm looking at, I don't know what I'm looking at, but I want this whole house fixed. Mm-hmm. Right? Right? So you just walk around like, I think that's the roof. I think this is the floor. Something's not right here. Right? You see the restroom, there's nothing sitting. Right? So you can be that lame and take pictures and you can upload it into this platform and put an open bid out to say, look, but I know I have about $20,000 to get all of this done. The contractors that are certified through the site are going to start bidding auction style. To say, I want that property.
I've heard somebody else. There's something similar to this, I think, with fixing stuff in your house, too. My girlfriend used it.
Exactly, the same company, right?
I don't know if it was Home Depot or whoever she went through, but they have something similar where you could do that and upload it, and then the contractors start sending emails saying,
you're right. And yeah, and there are a lot of those ones out there, so I won't say this is the same one. I'll say there are a lot of them out there that will bid. There's not a lot of them that does what we call reverse auction. Saying, I want to fight to get you the lowest number. So then somebody can say, well, I do all that for 20,000. The other one may say 18. The other one may say, I can go out for 15. And you say, well, I look at your work, because on the site, you can look at their work. Yeah, and see that you may not like their work. So they say, well, I see why you do 15. I'm going to do 18. Thank you. Right? And they're held up under an accountability system, one of the first platforms of this kind. That leveled the playing field. Because the hardest part about real estate investing is your contractors. Are you going to come back on time? Are you going to do what you said you're going to do? The quality in which I need? What does it look like? I don't know what your stuff looks like. Let me see your work. So on this website, you actually get to see the videos. You get to see their still shots. And they're under a accountability where you can go back and say, 2-star, they didn't do the good work. So they're on there knowing that they're going to get some real, you know, response, real time from your work and what they've done with you. Showed up on time, left on time, did quality work. They're a partner of our system. So when we bring you on with us, you actually are going to be able to utilize that platform to be able to get the deals and estimates done. The other way is we actually have a network. When you're a member of our network, we have a network that have partnership. We talk about you have a partnership with our membership with REIA Group, Real Estate Investment Association. We have group buying power for all of your paint, Home Depot, all that stuff is greatly discounted. Granted, pretty much everything you need to get a house done, we have inside our network at a discount rate. The contracts we have that we utilize to get our properties, and I will give you an example of a property while we're eating lunch. I'll let you see the property that we've done. From there, you've got to see the quality. We do work with Amish, African-American, Hispanic. We have white American. We have everyone working on properties. If they're good, they're good. And Amish are really very good.
Right, yeah, they're working. And they give you an honest, fair rate.
They're quick, and they hit all the drywall. You know what I mean? They have stuff to get like what you got going on here. So they pretty much are very, very into their craft. And that's what we got to respect it. But we do have Amish crews that we work with. And so we get pricing that can help all of us in that space. Got it? So what I would say is you don't have to worry about finding the contractors because we have them. But you can also find your contractors. And in my portion of that, I'll tell you that contractors are created, not hired. So you find a good contractor, lead person, you can find them on Craigslist, interview them, a general contractor, person that knows a little bit of everything. You want to look for a person that is a carpenter. Why a carpenter?
The structure is one of the most important parts.
It is. Exactly. Carpenters generally can do this wood, this floor, they generally can get into framing, drywall. They generally are going to know a plumber, electrician, and all the other people. So if you want to build your own crew, start with a carpenter or a maintenance man. And then you can build around them. But you want to start that way if you want to be building. General contractors, if you're going to use a hard money lender, you got a fixed budget that you know is going to work, it's a movement, we can go to general contractor. A general contractor is just a licensed contractor. Is licensed to lead another group of subs. And he's going to give you a 20% minimum premium over top of whatever price and knowing would cost it just to oversee his subs. So they're good on one end, but on a $20,000 project, you'll spend $24,000 to $26,000 and something that I can throw your budget off. So you don't always have a luxury of just handing it off. The Chinese guy that kind of got, when I first got in business, kind of gave me my wisdom around building my first, you know, million in business. He talked about learning every aspect of real estate before you turn it loose to someone else. So when I look at his room, somebody come in and tell you it's $1,000 to paint his room. I say, no, this room is gonna cost me about $175 to paint this room. You know what I mean? But if you don't know, somebody go $600 on this room, or somebody go $50 and then they got paint all over your wood. So I know that this room, when I'm looking at it, I know they're going to need a scalpel or just a ladder, whatever the case may be. And I'm looking at all the stuff that's going to happen inside of here. So I'm like, okay, I'm able to judge by how much time. They tell me it's going to take 4 days to make the room at $700. I'm like, well, what happened? But you only know that because you interacted with it. So once we start moving, I do encourage, and that's what Kim does. Kim actually comes over and she interacts with the property. Got it? So, let's make sure we're doing that. Okay. Food will be here in a minute, and then we'll be able to eat, and then we can ask questions and dialogue around that. I'll show you those pictures. And then for those of you that are coming with us, about 12 minutes down the road, we'll go to that house and do the walkthrough, and I'll show you what to look for and find the property like we had earlier. Got it? Questions?
I heard somewhere about someone being their own general contractor.
Did
you mention about having a license to be a
contractor? Right.
What are your thoughts on that?
You can be that if you understand the business enough to be the general. But you're basically, what they're saying, they're going to go downtown and set themselves up as a general contractor, license and insurance on them. And they're going to sell out to the other contractors. And that's fine, but sometimes what happens is people don't necessarily... understand the how to oversee other contractors. So sometimes that's kind of the issue. You know, it's like, well, I don't really know what to do, but I'm trying to tell you what to do.
So would someone do that just because they want to save money? What would be the advantage
of their own contractor? To try to save money because they know, yeah, they would say, well, I'm going to keep that 20%. I'll leave my own self. Got it. What do we want?
We want wings. No. Wings, we have some, what else did we get? We got some chicken, popcorn chicken, we got some fries, we got a salad, and that's it for now.
They have those,
they have flatbread.
Yeah, flatbread is shareable.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, what is the flatbread? Y'all, anybody like flatbread? Yeah.
You like flatbread? Okay.
Did y'all see? Look on the appetizers. If there's names and stuff that we didn't get, that y'all may want to eat. Two. Anything else?
Cheese curds are real good.
It's on charade.
Right.
It's everything on charade. So order now. Please, we can blame it on her. All right, name them out real quick before she goes. Anything y'all see that you didn't say? Cheese curls. Oh, the firecracker rolls. Those are real good.
Sounds good. Yeah. Flatbreads.
You see, flatbreads and firecracker rolls.
Sounds good to me.
Yep. All right, a couple of those. Okay. All right, so we'll just share. Mm-hmm. Kind of my goal is, like, I like to be able to have three to low cost units feed you. You know, earn your business in that nature. Prove what I can do, and then you can roll that kind of deserving way. How am I doing so far on information? Are you, you good? You learned something? Okay, see you, right? Okay, we have one last topic on here that we'll go over. You good on the contractors? I understand that. We will reveal that partnership the next week. They're coming on with us. It's a very easy platform to use. They're based out of Cleveland. The gentleman that owns it, runs it, is a real estate educator that also educates, works, and is a part of our local RIA group. Our RIA group is a real estate investors association that meets once a week. The next meeting is on the 12th of February. Free for first time guests, so we'll get your pass if you want to come. Of course, if you're a member, you automatically are included for the first 3 months. Membership there is $297. So when you're joining with us, you get already a quarter, 3 months, which is valued at $100 just from our end. So we automatically include you in that membership. And real estate investors associations are pretty much the supporting local area association to make sure investors have fair play in real estate. They fight legislation to make sure Section 8 laws, buy fix flip laws, all that stuff is intact. And then they have education and stuff like that as well. They don't do hands-on training like we're doing. They're more of an association. Come out, get updated on what's going on, what's in the news. Got it? Yes?
I have a question about the 5-1.
I
heard
that.
I guess I just
need to
understand
it.
I know you said there were some bullet points on.
I can't hear
your
question.
I'm going to repeat it.
What is the difference between the two?
The difference between a hard money and private money lender is what you're asking about. and I didn't go much into them. I kind of merged them. They're really very similar. Sometimes when they've been a little different, it's in their interest rates and their qualifications. A lot of hard money lenders may be a little bit higher on interest rate, but they have zero qualifications. It's like, look, we don't care what you have, as long as you got a pulse, we're gonna find you. Private money lenders are the ones like we just talked about here earlier, where they more are a little more focused on credit, experience, and down payment. So that's how you think hard money, think hardest case, private money, think more, you know, more exclusive, more a little bit higher level funding. That's the biggest difference I've seen. I started off, and I want to desensitize you in this area. I started off with 18% interest rate on my first deal. I started off with paying $20,000 to my coach, got $300 with no membership. There was no group economics. A gentleman named Frank West, which I need to figure out where he's at to this day, introduced me to that and Legal Shield, prepaid legal at that time. And I didn't understand prepaid legal, but I understood I wanted to get in real estate. And I got in there and he said, I'll help you get through your first deal. You're paying 50% of the profits. And we signed on, similar, but it wasn't as elaborate as this. We met at a Starbucks on Chagrin and Warrensville Center. I went out, I found the property, 1513-1515 Pontiac, East Cleveland 44112, and this was 2003. Two family house, I found a hard money lender. They're not around at this time, Tom Laurie. Main Street Financial was on the west side, and I got my hard money loan. It was around 50-something, $47,000. Bought the house, got the money to fix it up. Did not have a good contractor system, so I met all the worst ones in the beginning. Plumbing was shooting to the electric was through the plumbing. Together, they fried the HVAC. It was horrible. I mean, I was hot. Still made $40,000. Gave him 20, I took 20, I was officially in the game. And from there I started building. I failed forward. But because of that, it helped me to understand the ugly side of it. And I started building systems. Some that you'll see as I begin to move properties. You start seeing some of the systems I use for managing contractors, some of the systems like how I layer. Sometimes you go in the house, you just start painting. Ooh, it's pretty. Be like, wait a minute, anybody forget to put the electrical plumbing in? All right, we got to cut back into the walls. Or somebody paint, but they didn't properly sand and prep the walls. As easy as that sounds today, it happens. They put a floor down with no subflooring. Or one time a plumber put my, I gave him a price that I thought was awesome. He didn't agree, but he did not allow, you know, some people internally communicate. And contractors are one of those people, they internally communicate. They can tell you all types of stuff on the inside that you probably wouldn't want to hear in church on Sunday. I done bidding them down like, God, oh, this is a great price. I can work with this. Him and a roofer on this one house. Horrible story. But then I get to the property, get ready to sell it to the young lady, and I'm testing everything, and I got him on the plumbing. I said, well, you on this plumbing? I just got this budget. Man, we can't, man, please, I need it. All right, we got it. They did the bathroom. So I get in there and she said, well, my tub isn't working. Oh yeah, why not? I get in there, I'm like, it's just a turner.
We know the same contract.
Right? So then I go in there and I'm like, well, the water, so I call you, hey man, everything look good in here, but you know, the water isn't coming off. You know, you didn't have your budget for us to connect it to the plumbing. Oh. Now this is a whole steel surround and everything. Everything's done. Who wants to hear that, right? So now there's certain systems called roughing in your plumbing. So I have an inspection I do when they rough in the plumbing. Roughing in is saying I'll pull the plumbing all the way out and it's sitting out there that I do an inspection to make sure that I see the plumbing. It's capped, it's ready to roll, all the plumbing's on, all my electrical's pulled out. And then I inspect it, and then I let everybody do all their other cosmetic, and then I come back and do my finished plumbing, my finished light switch and electric and stuff like that. So now I have inspection things versus letting them turn loose. Painters cannot just paint. You have to show me the walls prepped before you paint. Because once they paint over them, it's hard to let the sand and stuff back off to get them back smooth to then turn around and put kilts and primer back over. So there's processes to that. Don't just throw my carpet down. I want to see the floor. You walked into the house before and the floor is like, what's up under here? Mm-hmm. But it's way in the middle. You can't get the carpet back up, but you got a groove in the floor. Who wants that? So it's like, well, no, they didn't do it. Well, you didn't pay for something. Right? Roofer did me the same way. Roof was beautiful, but I wasn't there for the inspection for the underlayment. And it rained and it was like a little waterfall. I wanted to tell her that was part of the features. It was like, no, that's supposed to be that way. It rained so bad. I was so like, it was bad. I had to go back. We had to fix that. That was like one of my, you know, early stage properties. I learned in that. Running your water. He's just tips I want to give you, just so you know how important it is to use coaching and the guidance in doing this. Finish the whole house. It looked immaculate over on Greenwich. I think that was 116 something. But, 10606 Greenwich. But all the water, so you run the water in the house, but most people think, oh, the water's running, I'm good. Well, you don't think to run it for like a whole day. Because most of the time, the water runs, it drains, it's good, you turn off. Who really runs the water for a full day? But if a house has been sitting for a year or two, or 2 or 3 years, and the drain tile, which is beneath the basement floor, is broken, which Cleveland Heights has a lot of those, by the way, because whatever they clay they use, a lot of them deteriorate. So a lot of these homes in inventory are different. Bedford basements are, there's a lot of water over there. Cleveland Heights has a lot of deteriorated basements with water. Everyone has a different stock of inventory, which is why when we're talking, we'll help you navigate that stuff. But under the bottom, the lady moves in, tenants move in, everybody's hunky-dory. I sold the house, tenants in. This is months later. I'm profits, spending money, everything. Somebody says, oh, tub is backing up. So I get the phone call, tub is backing up. Go in, hey, tub is backing up. Hey, LaRick, it's not stopping. All right, let's plunge it on out, let's snake it. Snaked it all the way down. When they come back, it's dirt on the snake. What does that mean? No dirt in that pipe. Yeah. That means it went out into the dirt, this outside the actual drain tile. So that is the space that what happened was the drain tile was busted, so we had to go back in. It's about $2,500, really it's about a $3,500 job. So we all fight at that point. Me, the contractor, who really to blame? I just spent half the money. I don't want to go back, even though I'm into more money. I don't want to go back and spend $35 on a house I flipped and just made about $5,000-$6,000. But had to go back in, had to cut it out, then had to come back and put in a whole other drain tile system under the basement floor. They'd be concrete and repainted. So these are reasons why you have systems and coaching and teams to help you move through your first project. There's a lot of stuff that you would not know to know in the beginning. Got it? So with that being said, the last thing I'll close out on is why use a realtor to flip my house, and then food should be coming out, but we can ask questions and I'll show you the pictures. Realtors, I kind of talked about in the beginning, to flip a property. And you may already know this, but I just want to just reinforce it. The multiple listing service is the most powerful marketing engine in real estate. It tells everybody that your house exists. And everybody's looking for houses that's near your house that your house exists. So they may find that $100,000 or $90,000 home in the same area, five streets over, and your street didn't have anything to sell. But five streets over and two blocks down, there's a house that's sold for $95,000. It looked just like yours. It was on the market at the same time. And the person says, well, I want to go see all the houses in this area. Well, they missed your street by driving around for your for sale by owner, your Facebook post. They ain't your friend, right? So then MLS says, for a couple of dollars, I'll tell everybody that you exist. Now, most people say, well, that's 6, 7, 10% that I got to add on to my money. So $90,000, I got to add another, if it's 10%, $9,000 on top of it. That's profit I can have, right?
Yeah.
That's why people avoid it. With our system, we have special negotiated fees that are flat fees then we will get you out on the MLS. So it will be in accordance to the deal, and it'll be fair. So our agent gets paid, and you are able to make money. So we have a partnership, not only with the self-directed IRA company, not only with the contractor system, not only the private money company, but we also have a partnership with the real estate agency that allows us to be able to make deals work so that everybody gets paid. Because they realize at the end of the day, you did all the work to make the money. So at the end of the day, they're not really selling your house. They're marketing the house that you have is going to sell and make them money. Versus if they just came up with your first time home that you had in the last 15 years is good looking to you, but then they're really going like, Lord have mercy. I have to put a sign down. I got to do all these places to try to get this house, somebody to like your house. When we renovate the house to spec, then it gets easier on the realtor. Now we just need a realtor to be our marketing partner. That's a different fee. And that's what the partnership we have. Everybody understand that? Everybody don't know that. And I guarantee you, there's a lot of people in these classes, they never teach that part. Because they're too busy telling people, get away from the real estate agents versus real estate agents are entrepreneurs in the business too. Just negotiate with them. Got it? So that, let's see. Any questions around that part right there? No? You good? All right, so slide recap, and I'll tell you about this program, and then the food should be coming out. Off-market properties are what, anybody? Not on MLS, what are we found at? Posted on Facebook.
Tax
sales. Tax sales. Signs in the neighborhood. Word of mouth. All right, and can I use a 401k to fund my deal?
Yes.
Yes. Who do I need to contact to do that?
Alan.
All right. Private money and hard money, are they extremely different or very close to each other? What do they specialize in doing? To do what? To get a property. To do what with the property? To flip it. You as a person or you as a business?
Yes.
Are the fees going to be as low as the bank?
No.
But are they going to be worth it?
Yes.
Right. Are we sensitive to their interest and what they're making?
No.
No, because we're doing what?
Making money.
What can we do with those fees? Tax time. Write them off. You know what I mean? Y'all get that?
Yes.
So it's business expenses. There you go, in the whole scheme of things. What makes our contractor system different than what people normally would have to do? What made it get easier? The ability to do what? How does our contractor system do? Use the bidding platform, interviewing, being able to use, so mainly being able to use our platform that we have to upload projects that you have so they can tell you how much your value of this project is worth and fight. So we'll reconcile until we know it. We'll let them fight to tell us what it's worth. Got it? And why should we use realtors? The number one reason we should use realtors.
Marketing
to what? Keep it honest to, because they know about the business and they can get in more or what?
Wait, who can
do
what?
No, they that sounds like something I want to say. Who can do what? More exposure.
Yeah.
All right. We also have a round of applause for having that pop quiz. Right. This packet, I'll email you, but those that feel like they will want to possibly sign up today, I have a packet up here. Basically, you have three ways that you can work, four ways that you can work with myself and my team. One is called Program One, Invest. Use an E, I didn't spell it correctly. That's what they say when I was in school. As E is for entrepreneurship through real estate. Invest. This is our network. It's called E-Network. True Self E-Network. Power Educated Employee. That's our network. Program number one is group house flipping. You can earn anywhere from 10 to 20% interest on your contribution to a project, or we can do a partner revenue share, depending on what your group wants to do. But if you want to be totally hands off, you make 10 to 20% return on your money. You put your money in, you get your money back, and you keep going until you get enough money to be able to do it on your own. Or if you say, no, I want to get my hands dirty, I want to be there getting the materials, being the contractor, stuff like that, then we can talk about, in that group, making a revenue share, splitting the profits. Got it? In that group, the criteria is you have $2,500, $5,000, or $10,000. If there's a need to go beneath that, then you would just let me know, and we would look at creating an individual, you know, a different scenario. But who we're mainly looking for is $2,500, $5,000, $10,000. So you and your family may say, look, we can come up with $2,500. Or we may talk about something else. Anybody get that? $2,500, $5,000, $10,000. You're not investing your money in me, you're investing your money in the project. And you got paperwork and contracts that show it. Legal requirements. You must be an incorporated business entity by your second project. In the beginning, you can start off moving, right? You start investing, first of all, because we use loan agreements, we don't use investment language, because you're not, we call it projects that you're investing to, but they're loan agreements. So there's a loan to the project, and you need a loan plus a percentage back on. By the second deal, though, you must have an LLC. Got it? No experience is required. And then you must be a member in order to be in this group. Membership is $299, and you must have it's around $43 a month, Legal Shield membership. That covers your business, that gives you your tools, that gives you access to a lawyer, so that you can, because I'm kind of like forcing you to have a lawyer. Like, I don't want you to ever say it. I was the last conversation. So it protects you and allows you to be able to, you got food?
Food is being set up right here.
Oh, okay. Good.
So everyone can come out.
Oh.
Plates there.
Okay. Is it enough?
There's still plenty more food.
Okay. All right. Okay. I'll speed up.
Okay.
All right. So that's that. Everybody understand that? $299 includes a membership to the RIA group. One-time payment plus Legal Shield for the out of about 340-something on board. And then that puts you in the group that starts investing. I'll go back to that in a second. Program two, wholesale. Partner with the Real Biz Coach to wholesale properties in Cleveland, mainly, or other hot markets throughout the country. I do some stuff in Atlanta. I do some stuff in North Carolina. $1,500 coaching retainer is required, so you must have $1,500 plus a $500 marketing budget to get into that. You say, Rick, I got $1,500, I got $500 to market. So we're going to market to tell people we look at the properties, and then we're going to find that $20,000 deal, and we're going to host up to $5,000, and we're going to share in revenue. So together, we're going to walk through that. Now, I partnered with a gentleman called Rob the House Guy. He's an expert in wholesaling, and we do that with him. So we'll talk about that particular one later. Legal requirements, none. You can do that without an LLC. Minimum US that you will make on that is $1,500 per contract till you get your money back. So you put up $1,500, you get the $1,500 back on the first deal. So it's pretty easy to have to have to make your money. $500 is still being used as marketing, but you can make that on the second deal. Must be a member. Everything's going to end up being a member. So I want you to be a part of us. You know, at the end of the day, I want you just. And it's like the community, the culture, we believe in education. We believe in some things that we do as membership. You know, I got a young men initiative I'm working on right now where I'm called to kind of really just help young men and kind of break some psychological change that I may have been caught up in. And I'm going to be helping and teaching them real estate and things of that nature like that. You know, man, right back there. What's up, young man? You fit. I'm looking at you. I'm watching you. So program. So that's the wholesale partnership. Program three, team up with the Real Biz Coach to flip your first property. So if you want to actually come together and you say, look, I like the people, but I'm a real introvert. I have my own money, like Rob, I got bank for days. So then I'm going to partner. Yeah. at the Pit Bull Real Estate. So, so anyway, we could just have a side conversation. I'm working with the person right now and saying, no, I just want you to flip properties to me directly. I have my money. I'll give my IRA credit. And I just want to work with you directly. Totally fine. Or me and my family just want to work with you directly. Totally fine. So that's that part portion. And, but here it goes. You must have $20,000 to pull me aside. So I'm not going to hustle up with you. You got to have $20,000 to work it after a project, a 620 credit score and above. So, and then I'll bring the experience. And then we will go and leverage a hard money lender and we will do probably, I'll bring my whole team, my resources, all that stuff to do the project. And then we turn around and we split 50-50 of the net just like Frank West did. He did to me, so it's fair for me to do it to you. No, but that's the way it works. It's easy to split on down the middle and we make money together and you learn the business. In that, you just have to have your $20,000 and a $1,500 retainer to retain me for us to go look for properties together, and then Erica comes with us and we go find some properties. So that's just me working with you as an investor, from your first house. And then the last one is just, you say, well, I don't need anything but your private money. I got contractors, I have the knowledge, I have all that, I got a 620, I got all that. What I like about what you just said is the money. I want to see Rob in the back, and I want to get qualified to get private money, and I'm about to go about my way and make it happen. There's no requirements there other than CLOB. And then you can get connected to all private money lenders and then make it happen for yourself. Everybody get it? Cool with that? All right. So as the food is coming out, I don't want to do no pressure sale. Like, who's in? Right on, man. You know, like that. So we can dialogue. Y'all have some food and we will. Talk, I'll put the music on, and then we will shoot down to the other property. All right? I'm going to email, this is going to be emailed to everybody. But if you feel like it's something you seriously are considering, then I'll, you know, share a pack with you and go ahead and read the whole thing. And please go out and grab some food.
More is coming out as well.
Yeah. All right, the first piece of y'all, give yourself a round of applause. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Are you still recording?
Oh, that's good. Hey, Facebook, I hope y'all got something out of the way.
Got another one from another state interested in Cleveland.
Oh, good.
I actually.
Yeah. I know. Interested in looking at the property.
Keep this going, the webinar.
Yeah.
It's only us. Alan got off.
Okay. Now,
I didn't see him. It was two at first, and then it went back to one, and then that's when Alan got on. So.
Why you trying to be?